The Grand Conjuration by Opeth. I am extremely familiar with this song. I've listened to it countless times, mostly because Ghost Reveries is one of my favorite Opeth albums. It might be my favorite. I'm not able to pick one, honestly. They have some really, really good albums. This is not one of my favorite tracks on the album, although this might be one of my favorite metal choruses ever. Whenever it comes to that metal chorus, I have to put the whiskey down. It's this important. Ooh. Because you're coming to the part where it's building up. Like, I know it for fucking beat for beat. Because it's so pounding. It fucking pounds it right through you. So damn good. With the growls on top of it, too, counteracting the, what's the word for that kind of beat where they go dun, 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 dun?
Like a syncopation?
Syncopation, thank you, sorry. The vocals going over top of the syncopation of all of the rhythm, and then with the keys in the background kind of accenting the chords, because they're just hitting one note. And that gives the keys the ability to make all these interesting, cool chords that kind of meld around it. It gives you this badass, like, the devil's rising from the grave type of shit. It's fucking awesome. And then the second time they get to that chorus, it's followed up by this ripping solo, which is one of my favorite Opeth solos. Amazing. Here's the thing, though. When you start off your song, it's like the worst Phrygian phrase I've ever heard in my life. It's like, it reeks of cheese, man. It really does. I love Opeth to death, but I really don't like the main theme of the song. However, I have to acknowledge that chorus and the bridge and everything wouldn't be as awesome as they are without that main theme.
And this is where Mike and I seem to differ on metal. We both play together, and I think we got some chemistry going on. But as far as I'm on the Asking Alexandria, the more punk side of metal, he's more on the progressive side of metal.
More on the Metallica side of metal.
Metallica side of metal. Yeah, agreed. This song was not my jam. I listened to it just like the audio, and it didn't really catch my ears. There's nothing special about it. And it was Opeth. I know how much Mike loves Opeth, so I was like,
This is not the song I would show to you to introduce you to Opeth. That's well, one of the that's one of the regrets I have of picking this for Songs Edition Friday. We need to everyone in the comments section, tell him we need to introduce him to Blackwater Park. Blackwater Park in the comments section. Flood it. Flood it, guys.
Flood, 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 flood,
flood. But yeah, I was like, well, I'll give this a redemption shot, because I know Mike loves it so much. So I'll watch the music video.
Oh, no. Mistake.
Yeah, that's how I felt, too.
I never watch prog music videos. They're never good. They're never good.
Really, it was like trying to be really dark and evil, but it failed. It's just kind of like lame. Wasn't really scary. And the growl was
kind of like the main theme of the song. Yeah. Trying to be dark and scary, and it was just kind of lame and failed.
Yeah. Asking Alexandria is definitely more produced, whereas Opeth, I feel like, is underproduced. So the growl could have been beefier.
Oh, no, 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 hey. No, no. Oh. Oh. Wow.
It didn't hit it for me. It didn't do it for me.
And by the way, you're entitled to your opinion, and I'm fine with that. And I am fine with that.
See, I tend to find myself somewhere in the middle of the styles of metal. This is totally a song I would jam to. I love Opeth. They're an extremely tight band. Everything they do musically is awesome. Even though he has the best growling vocals, in my opinion, I still don't like growling vocals that much, so it still throws me off a little bit. But other than that, there's not hardly ever a thing I dislike about Opeth. I mean, their acoustic stuff is so dark and perfect. And
that's the thing. You need to listen to some of their, like, folkier stuff that they throw in between usually. Like, it's real. Oof. Dreamy.
Does not smell of cheese. You should see a doctor.
Total grade for this song, 2+ signs. Mostly because that chorus frickin' I have to stop. No matter what I'm doing, I stop and I air drum that entire syncopated beat. It's just great.
I will give this song an equal sign because I do trust Mike's taste in music. And so I'll, well, whether I chose negative or not, Mike would have shown me this stuff anyways. But yeah. I will go out and seek out some good Opeth because, I mean, everybody, I knew the name before I even knew Mike. So, I mean, I know they've got
Blackwater Park.
Thinking I'll probably Google Blackwater Park. I'll check them out a little bit. Hopefully redemption shot.
I honestly think it will be, dude, because they got some really, really good, especially like you appreciate the folk stuff, right?
Oh, absolutely, yeah.
Opeth has been described as progressive metal with a fusion of death metal, jazz, and folk.
See, that intrigues me.
Yeah, totally. And this was not that. This was just death metal and really awkward Phrygian theme.
I agree with all those things.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely give us a plus sign. This is the song I would put on if I had a rough day at work and wanted to drive home and jam some angry music. That's it.
Paranoid Android by Radiohead. One of my favorite memes I've ever seen on Facebook is someone is typing in Radiohead into Google search and it auto-completes as Porcupine Tree for 4/4 plebs. To be fair, this actually had some sections of 7/4 in it, so it's like, okay, you know, whatever. But I mean, there's a little bit of truth in that statement. I actually really like this song. I've told you guys before, I'm actually not a big fan of Radiohead, but I'm not sure if it's just because it's been so long since I've listened to them, or if it's because I just am listening to the right stuff that you suggest. I really like this track a lot, actually. It was very cool. The production was excellently done. And I know I've said before, I really don't like Tom York's vocals. I actually liked them on this track. I think they're pretty appropriate. This is very reminiscent of Muse.
Well, when I first heard the song back way, way, way long ago, like maybe even in my teens, I did not like the song. So I was kind of excited to hear it suggested. So I was like, oh, okay, I'm like ready to give this song a try because I think my musical taste has developed a little bit. And I did. I did like it a lot more this time. The chord progression was really cool. His guitar work is really cool. If you haven't watched Tim play it live, I highly recommend it. No joke, for the entirety of the song, he does this.
Who?
The lead singer for Radiohead. No, 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 he does that. I'm getting dizzy just doing it. But like, he did it for 8 minutes nonstop. Didn't open his eyes or anything. So that was pretty weird. And it's got, you know, the cool contrast from like that like really bizarre chord progression, like that really rocking riff he does and brings it back down and up again. Radiohead's great.
My biggest complaint about the song is that it wasn't Creep.
Just like a lot of Nirvana fans say that they really don't like Smells Like Teen Spirit, a lot of Radiohead fans say that they really don't like Creep. I actually do like the song. That was like the one Radiohead song I was like cool with. I have to disagree with Ryan because I'm happy it wasn't Creep, because while Creep is cool, this one had more of a prog feel to it, which is more up my alley.
Again, normally would be, but I've listened to more of their music than just Creep. I've heard a handful of their songs people have recommended me throughout the years, and they're like, yeah, check this out. It's kind of experimental and kind of proggy. I don't know. I felt like I waited too long for an impact that finally came and then wasn't long enough, and I didn't think it was that cool. I mean, the verse, the mellow kind of Latin feel was pretty cool, but I felt like it went too long. And then it went back to it, and I was like, all right, is the song almost over? Then it gets back to the impact, which I really didn't want to hear the second time, because I was just ready for it to be over. I just didn't like it.
I can actually see what he's talking about.
Yeah, I can see how you don't like Radiohead, because I was one of those people a while ago, and I'm not saying you even have to have developed musical taste. It is definitely you like it or you don't with Radiohead. Very experimental.
And on top of that, like, when he's saying, like, you know, never really came through and did, like, the punch through of the great emotional moment, I can kind of see that for sure. For me, there were a few moments where I felt like it was it, but that's kind of thing subjective, you know? Total grade for this song, plus sign.
Likewise, I'm going to give this a plus sign. It kind of revived my, my wanting to listen to Radiohead.
Gotta give it a minus sign.
Wow.
Not
going to actively avoid it?
just like when when the car won't start and you keep trying and you're listening for noises that are going to give you some inkling of whether it's going to start or not, then you remove the positive terminal in the battery to do some diagnostic. I'm giving it the negative.
I get
it. And then you take a shotgun and put Ol' Yeller down. Crack the Sky by Mastodon. This is great prog metal, like Mastodon always is. I wasn't so much of a fan of the growling vocals at the beginning. The growling vocals later in the song I actually enjoyed more. I don't know why, it's just something about the quality of them at that first verse that just really rubbed me weird. One of the things that they do with their production, it's either they have some kind of like phaser modulation or a doubling of the recording of the guitar, but they have this really thick sound that sounds so cool on the guitars, and that makes it for me. That really builds the soundscape and makes it from being a couple guys in a garage to like a mystical experience, if you will. It really takes it to the next level. I will say I did not like it as much as The Last Baron, which you guys had recommended to me in a previous video.
This, I've actually been turned on to Mastodon before, and the name is so heavy. Maybe that's why I'm always disappointed by Mastodon. There's nothing, I guess, inherently bad about Mastodon. I just don't really like them. Their guitar work is, I'm sure they know like their music theory and they apply it to the songwriting, which is important to me. It's not my style. Sorry, guys.
Yeah, there was hardly a thing about the song that I didn't like. I felt the same way about the growling vocals at the beginning, but what changed them for me was the actual singing was so good it redeemed them.
Totally.
I thought it was like everything was super tight. And all the little creepy sounding instruments and stuff throughout, just everything was really cool. I've listened to Mastodon before at someone's recommendation, and I don't know why I never continued to be into them.
Same here. For some reason, everyone tells me to listen to Mastodon, and I do. And then I just like never go seek them out again. I always enjoy listening to them. There's never been a negative Mastodon experience I've ever had. Just like, eh. Total grade for this song, plus sign.
Total grade for this song is a low end negative because I know a bunch of people like them. I don't want to hurt their feelings, but.
You mean a positive negative?
No. I know a bunch of my friends like them and stuff. So, I mean, it's not so bad that I've won turn off. I'm not going to personally look for them.
What sign?
Funeralopolis by Electric Wizard.
Someone recommended that to me in the comments. They said since I like new metal, I might like that song.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Did you say you liked new metal on my video?
Well, we were talking about new metal when we did that kind of clip last week. Yeah. I said I like Chevelle.
This is good stoner metal. That's exactly what this is. Straight up stoner metal. Not all the instruments are perfectly in beat with each other. There's really fat mid-ranged guitars and just super, super fuzzy tones. They play the same riff over and over and over again. To be honest, I felt like, what was it, 8 minutes?
Yeah.
I think 8 minutes was a little bit too long for what they had to say, personally. I think they could have reduced it to half the time and been just as effective.
Forever recommended that song, thanks. I had a different experience because I watched the music video first. If you have not watched the music video, epic. So, so epic. It's like the scenery is amazing. And it kind of like, it's kind of like movie music where you don't really keep up with it after a while. So I wasn't really like actively listening to the song. It's got this dude, he's like all painted on, like war paint. They got all these like Indians everywhere, and like it's like all rock, and they're like about to, they're just killing people, like got gore and stuff in there. Epic video, like movie status. You can tell it's kind of like cheaply made, but still great video.
Cheap movie status.
Yeah, it wasn't like, yeah, full on Warner Brothers status or anything like that, but it was good video. And that actually made me like the song, and then today I was listening to it again, and I didn't like it as much with just the audio. So, the experience of them the two together, absolutely. The just the audio by itself, if I was stoned and wanted to listen to some metal.
Oh, totally.
Yeah, really vibey, you know, got that heavy, just grinding bass riff. Cool song.
I've never been stoned, so I can't relate to what they're saying.
Me neither,
just
for the record.
Just listen to this song on repeat with your eyes closed for 10 days.
There's a lot of heavy fuzz, not my favorite style of mix. Bluesy guitar solo towards the beginning, that was kind of cool.
Yeah.
See, when I first started listening to it, all I heard was the rhythm guitar and the drums. After about a minute, I'm like, "What? There's got to be something else." And I heard something out of the side of my other ear. I didn't realize it was split between two headphones, so I had to go back, put the other headphone and go back and listen to the beginning again, because I missed like the whole...
Wait, are you saying you didn't realize that a song was in stereo format? Is that what you're telling me right now?
I know that songs are in stereo format.
But... All songs are in stereo format!
He listens to it on his phone, he's got a mono speaker.
No, I had headphones in, I had the full surround sound. <place. laughs>
No breaks will be given.
No breaks will be given!
Quality of mix in the one ear, I did not expect anything to be split between two sides in this recording.
Oh my goodness gracious. Have you ever listened to a Beatles recording? It's like not everything hard pan left, everything hard pan right. If you have one ear in, you're missing the whole, like half the song over here, literally.
Ben Sinful does that too, and I used to have a pair of headphones that didn't work.
Oh, it's the worst!
Oh, yeah.
That's a huge bummer.
One time the right side of my car speakers went completely out. I was listening to the City of Evil album. It's tough. Real tough.
Very sad.
That happened to me in my, well, we were dating at the time, but my ex's car, her one side speaker in her car would go out. While we were listening to Baroness, I'd kick the thing as hard as I can just to get her to freaking, the damn stereo to come on. I'm like, no, you don't get it. You're missing half the song.
The little jam part toward like the second half of the song was refreshing for about 10 minutes, but the last 30 minutes of it, I just felt like it dragged on that long. I feel like with all the fullness of the guitar tone being so deep, I don't know what word to use for it. So thick, fat. Yeah. Seeing that live would probably feel really good, like to get vibrated around, you know, by overall, I really did not enjoy my listening experience.
Total grade for this song, equal sign.
Total grade for this song is a plus sign, because I probably will be showing that music video to a couple friends. Like, that was cool.
And in order to reach equilibrium, I will give this song a minus sign.
Ooh.
Okay.
I'll be right back. Get more whiskey?
Yes.
Whiskey.
Why am I saying what? What way?
So if you guys were paying attention to my whiskey glass, I just had to fill it up because of the last song we're going to review today. Oxygen by Swans. I never thought the words, I wish I had those poor bastards back, would ever come out of my mouth. But they just have, and I mean them.
Glory, amen.
Glory, amen's a masterpiece compared to this. This is by far the most annoying vocalist I've ever listened to in my life. I don't care about what kind of affect they were trying to go for. I don't care what kind of message they were going to send. I don't care if they have the best of intentions. They should stop making music. Let me rephrase that. They should stop making this music. This is the worst shit. Oh my God. This might be the worst thing I have ever listened to, with the exception of One Night at a Time by George Strait.
Ooh.
I have an entire video on that. Go watch it.
I'm sure you don't have many George Strait fans on this.
It's like saying you hate God in hell. It's like, no duh.
Well, somebody thought they had a sweet bass riff. They decided to play that bass riff 800 times. Yes, I counted the BPMs and the length of the song.
Really?
It's over 800 times.
Oh my God.
The reason the cheese. I put effort into this is because, as a guitarist...
You needed to objectively measure how terrible the song was.
Well, Frank Zappa actually would make terrible songs intentionally so that the vocals would pierce your ears so hard, like it would get that message across. This guy didn't even do that right. He just made it so terrible. I'm like... Well, Mike said you have to commit to listening to the whole song.
Yes.
And
yes,
so I did.
I did too.
And I even tried to listen to it a second time because I wanted to see the video. Like, I had to see this band. It's what you expect. The guy is like 50 years old, looks like he's had plastic surgery and done a lot of psychedelic drugs. You know, when the bass is like, dan, 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 dan. Like, he's like doing like interpretive dance and stuff. It's great. If you haven't, I don't recommend you listen to this song, but I do recommend you watch at least the first 30 seconds of them performing it live, because that was the only great thing I got out of that entire experience.
Maybe Cool Tool should cover it. 50 comments.
Oxygen!
I needed oxygen after that song.
I needed fucking morphine after that song.
Initially, the first couple of seconds, I thought it was going to be a cool song. And then the guy with the speech impediment started yelling things.
That might be the worst part, is we almost thought this was good for a second. It's like we opened our hearts to it, and it stabbed us hard in the fucking back.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not a fan of Rage Against the Machine or anything like that, but it's almost like he was trying to do those vocals without being able to do those vocals. And then the middle of the song, whatever horn sample they used, it sounds like an elephant blaring over and over again.
I think that's intentional, by the way.
Well, that elephant's using up all my oxygen. I want it back.
So can we agree that this is in contention for one of the worst bands ever?
Yeah, I'd say we can all three of us give us the rating at the same time, even.
All right. Total grade for this song, minus sign, would actively seek to destroy. Now time for our suggestions. I have two suggestions this week. First is The Boxer by Simon and Garfunkel. I don't know how many of you guys are actually into folk. Simon and Garfunkel are some of the kings of folk music, especially from the flower power period of time. The Boxer is one of those songs where it's kind of like has the emotional impact of metal without being metal. I did a metal cover of Hazy Shade of Winter by Simon and Garfunkel. One of the guys who was a friend of the producer, it's like a friend of a friend of a friend, listened to it and said he would have funded me to do a metal version of The Boxer. Well, I'm gonna wind up doing my own version of The Boxer. Guys, take a listen to it. It's a fantastic song and actually has a great story as well as being musically beautiful. Live and Learn by Crush 40. Yes, I just recommended the song from Sonic the Hedgehog.
Yes!
If you haven't listened to the song, it's just awesome. It's just good video game power metal. I'm sorry, it's my guilty pleasure. I love the shit out of it. I do not like Sonic the Hedgehog, but I love the shit out of this song. It makes me want to live and learn.
Can you feel alive? Living through your spine. Oh, but you came back for more. Yeah!
Okay. I think the worst part was he was snapping to it like it's a doo-wop.
Yeah, I also have two suggestions. Since I mentioned He Is Legend, look up I Am Hollywood by He Is Legend. Super heavy. Like, this is the closest thing to thrash I've ever thoroughly enjoyed. It is so satisfying. I actually got caught rocking the F out in my car next to my girlfriend by another car. Of four teenagers that mocked me terribly. And it was, but it was worth it. It does still hurt to this day. Second one is a band called Vasudeva. They have a full audio tree session, but my favorite song is Tuxford Falls. It's two guitarists, no vocals. The drummer gets his influences from dance beats, which is really cool. They both use Gibson SGs, and the lead guitarist is mainly like one of those really heavy tappers, but not really like metal, repetitive tapping, more melodic, very alive sounding, almost like Chon, if you guys know Chon.
I've never seen the movie Tron, sorry.
Watch
it's
it.
It's John! That was gonna bother me forever.
My suggestions for you are How I Go by Yellow Card. I'm a huge fan of overprocessed punk, and Bring It On. I've been made fun of for listening to that in my car way too loud. Timpani drums, all that stuff included. Do it. It's good music. Listen to it. Be a man. Or a woman. My second suggestion for you is XOXOXO by Secret and Whisper. It's a band out of Pennsylvania, pretty close to where Mike and I grew up.
Oh, do you know those guys? You saw them at a show once?
I've never seen them at a show, but they are an awesome band nonetheless, and they've never been in a Taylor Swift music video. It's a good jam. The whole album is good, but that's probably the best jam song on the album. Highly recommend it. The guy's got some high-pitched wailing vocals that I think you'll enjoy.
Guys, thank you so much for joining us again for Song Suggestion Friday. Leave your comments in the comment section below of what you want us to listen to next week. Guys, go subscribe on Patreon. $5 a month. You can vote on what songs we listen to. I mean, if you guys want us to listen to amazing stuff, go and throw the suggestions, vote it up. If you guys want us to listen to something that makes us want to end our lives, go in, throw in the suggestions, vote it up. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. See you in the next video.
Rock on!